Now we move on to how critical chain operates in execution. We expect things to not go as planned. As the project progresses, both tasks T1 and T7 essentially finish on time. After task T8 has been worked on for a time, an update is provided that estimates the remaining duration. And this shows an end time of T8, which is later than the original aggressive estimate. In this case, the delay is absorbed by the gap that existed between T3 and T4. When the next update is received, the estimated end date for T8 is even later. This delay affects the rest of the project and impacts the project buffer. Note how task T11 is also affected due to the fact that it uses the same resource as task T8 and T3. So T11 will not get access to this resource until T3 is done with it. But since T6, which is the integration point, is also moved right, there is currently no feeder buffer impact. Let us review. T1 and T7 finished on time. T8's duration was longer than its planned aggressive duration. First portion of T8's delay absorbed by gap between T3 and T4. Rest of delay impacted the project buffer. T11 also affected due to resource constraint. Current project status, 7% complete with 30% buffer consumed. Note, many complicated interactions can be occurring, but as we will elaborate, the project manager just needs to monitor buffer impacts, which is much simpler.